So let's talk about states like Virginia. I mean, that should be solidly Democratic, I think, but some people have that as a bit of a toss-up at the moment. What's your read on Virginia right now?
I think the sense in Virginia, you obviously have a Senate race. Tim Kaine, who is Hillary Clinton's running mate, is up for re-election in the Senate. There's a couple of very important congressional seats, House seats, that are up that the Democrats need to win or protect in the fall. And I think you'll see a lot of money being spent by the Democrats in here in Northern Virginia, the Washington, D.C. area, as well as a little further south down in what is the Virginia Beach area here. A largely urban African-American area. But I think the Democrats, you know, keep an eye on Virginia. But I think on election night, Virginia would be one that people will be surprised if it's not called early for the Democrats.
Yeah, no, look, I think that's probably right. But just you mentioned the African-American vote. We hear a lot about that starting to shift to Trump, you know, in some considerable numbers, according to some polls. How much of that do you think is actually real? And, you know, given some of the urban concentrations, would that shift some big votes in big states with a lot of electoral votes but high urban populations, like New York or Illinois?
James, I think I don't think we worry about New York or Illinois, but I do think the Democrats are paying close attention to the African-American vote. Let's take a step back. Let's look at the former president's numbers for just a second, because it's important too. I think he's got a very low ceiling. I think he's stuck and always will be in this election at 42 or 43%. He's not going to get any more than that. So the best way for him to win is to weaken the base of the president's accomplishments with places like the African-American vote around the swing states. So he's got to either do one of two things. He's got to attract former Biden voters over to him, or I think what's more likely to happen is people become disinterested and don't come out and vote on Election Day in November. So I don't see the African-American vote going for—and we're really talking about 20- to 40-year-old African-American men. I don't see them going in large numbers for former President Trump. The big issue for the Democrats is, how do you get them out to come out and vote on Election Day for the President of the United States, for President Biden? So I think it's something that people are paying very close attention to. But, there, you know, I think you may have also seen in the news last week, the president and vice president launched a big initiative last week to focus on African-American voters. They kicked it off up in Philadelphia, which, you know, is not only the president's home turf, but also a state, Pennsylvania, which he's got to win to be reelected.
Absolutely fascinating. Larry Grossman, CT Group, thank you so much for taking the time to join us on the U.S. Report.
Thank you
really appreciate
me.
It. Thanks, Larry.